This is a hatchery section. So you'll note that it is very much secluded from the rest of the farm. This is because of biosecurity reasons. So before you get to the hatchery, you must be fumigated. So this is a hatcher, and this is a setter. This is a 5,000 setter. That is a 5,000 hatcher. Actually 5,400 hatcher. So this is the mini section. And this is where we do research. This is a research center for maybe checking breeds, trying new breeds, trying to hatch and see how they'll perform. And the other side, we do the hatching for commercial of the broilers. So basically today, I want to take you through a very easy setup of how you can build your hatcher at home and you can set up your hatcher. So you need to have a table. This one, we call it a selection table. This one, basically, you'll use it for handling of eggs, like during loading to the incubators and during offloading the incubator and putting to the hatcher. So basically, here we also have another table. And you'll note that our hatcher is tiled, and it's actually the floor is tiled white up to this side of the wall, just for the purposes of maintaining hygiene. So you can find, for example, these are eggs. We are preparing for loading them to one of the machines. Incubator for experiment or for a lesson today. This is a 5,000 setter stroke 1,000 hatcher. So here is a tray. It's an 88 capacity tray. I had already started loading it before. So when you're loading the tray, you should try your level best and ensure that you get medium-sized eggs, eggs that are clean, eggs that are of the normal egg shape. That is, if you take such an egg, for example, such an egg is not very smooth and it's not very brown like it's supposed to be its usual color. So such an egg, we won't use it for hatching. So you will take an egg, such an egg, it's brown, it's smooth, it's clean. Then the egg should be oval, one side should be wider and one side should be narrow. So then when you are loading the incubator, when you're loading the tray, you then check the narrow side and pour it down, then the wider side, pour it up. So there we go. So you do that. Then quickly, we shall quickly select the good eggs. So I've just come across this egg. You find that there's some grass, it's not clean, and the egg is not, actually is oval, but it does not have a wider side and a narrow side. Both sides are the same. So for such an egg, you will not use it for hatching. So you separate it and put it aside. So you only get the medium-sized eggs. You see, I also have a round egg, and it's also whitish in color. So this one, I will actually ignore it. Then I will take this one. It's an average egg, nicely colored, and it's medium. So the narrow side, I'll pour it down. I'll take that, I'll take that, I'll take that, I'll take that, I'll take that. Then I load like that, like that, like that, like I'll take that, I'll take that, I'll take that. That, like that, and I will take that and that. So I will change this and this and this. I will replace here, here. Here, take that, take that, take that. So for the purposes of this video, I'm just gonna do for you one crate. So our crate is full. Then open the machine. So I will then open the machine. I will then check the eggs slowly, and then load them into our machine. Slowly, slowly. Slowly like that. So I'm assuming that you have already filled our machine. Our machine is full. Number one, never run the machine without water because it will burn down. So because I have connected my machine to the tap, so I will just take this pipe. Sorry. Then connect it to the machine. Connect it to the machine. Then I will load it with some water. So once it's full, remove the pipe, put it aside, and then close the machine. One important tip, before loading the eggs to the machine, make sure that the machine has been running for the last 6 hours. So try to make sure that the machine has been running for the last 6 hours successfully, the temperatures inside are okay. So then, you come here and then very close and focus on the panel. So down here we have a value written SV and up here we have a value written PV. So the SV means set value and the PV means present value. So here we have set 37.5 and inside the machine, which is PV, that is the present value, the temperatures are 27.3. Then our set value for humidity is 15, but inside the machine the present value is 85. So for you to set your eggs on the first day from day 1 up to day 18, you'll need to use a temperature of 37.5 and 65 for humidity. A temperature of 37.5 degrees and humidity of 65 units. So how do you set it? Then you press set. It will write TT on the SV on the right side. Then it will write 37.5. So it means the temperatures we have set 37.5, which is okay. But you can decrease or increase. Let's say, for example, we want to use 37.8 for our eggs. So we'll say, we'll increase, you'll press the button facing up, which is the arrow up. Then you say, you add. So for example, it's a 7.81. But now because you want 37.5, we can go back. So you just press the arrow facing down, like that, until you get to 37.5. So once it's at 7.5, then you're gonna press OK. It's going to go to the next value, which is HH. HH is the humidity. So here we want a humidity of 65 or 60. So you're gonna set it and just increase the humidity by using the same arrow pointing up or using the same button written up. Then you press, you can long press, so you can get to 65. After getting 65, you press OK. Then it's automatic because it will automate itself, so it will give you that 7.5 and it will give you 65. So the machine will put on the coils itself. That's why you see it has there's a green light here, meaning it has put on heater 1 and heater 2, so that it will increase this temperature inside the machine slowly up to 37.5. And then the humidity is at 85. So you can see heater 3 is off. Then you can see also wet bulb is off. So that means the machine will not heat the water. It will let the humidity go down slowly. And because the fan is running, so the fan will help us to reduce the humidity by escaping, actually by pushing out the humidity that is inside, just by the movement of the speed of wind, you know, some physics there. So basically, that is how you set your machine to run. Very complicated. Now we've reached, I'm assuming that you are using the same machine for hatching, or you're using the same machine again for setting and hatching. So let's assume that our eggs have gotten to day 18. So when you reach day 18, procedure. Thank you for watching. Subscribe. And then in our next video, we shall teach you how to put your eggs in the hatcher and how to set the panel for hatching.